evening, one and all, and welcome to a triumphant evening. Welcome to Musical Bouquet. I am Mike McGinnis, current director of our Berkley Downtown Development Authority. We are so honored and delighted to sponsor this evening's soiree and performance. And we really want to celebrate, first and foremost, the musicians. So let's give a preemptive, warm Downtown Berkley welcome to the WIndscape Trio. And similarly, we want to celebrate Pastor Zach Dunlap and the Berkley First family for being not only a true pillar of our Downtown Berkley community, but also for being so receptive and warm to this particular gathering. Please give a warm Downtown Berkley round of applause to Pastor Dunlap and the Berkley First family. Very briefly, before we get to the main event and why you're tuning in or with us this evening, we are all about bringing life, vitality, shoppers, and diners to the dynamic corridors of Downtown Berkley, Michigan. So, for the entire stretch of 12 Mile and the entire stretch of Coolidge, 1 mile and 1 mile, that's chock full of fun, excitement, and arts and culture. So keeping in that tradition, we are so delighted to be the presenting sponsor this evening of this musical bouquet. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Pastor Zach Dunlap to help cue us up. Welcome, sir.
Thank you so much, Mike. It's a joy to be a part of this dynamic and exciting community together with you. We also want to thank CMNtv for broadcasting tonight and Michelle Prudhomme assisting as tonight's usher. Whether you are joining us in person or via live stream, we are thankful you decided to give us a portion of your evening, and we hope that you enjoy the bouquet of tonight's music. Our first piece, London Trio No. 1, was originally written by Franz Joseph Haydn for two flutes and one cello. The piece was written in 1781 when Haydn was 58. At the time, he was visiting in London, where he was greatly admired and had a large circle of friends. This cheerful work would have been performed in a private home by some of his friends. The WIndscape Trio will perform all three movements of London Trio No. 1, Allegro, Andante, and Vivace.
Thank you.
together since 2017. Jenny Spenner on flute is a founding member and flutist with the Rochester Community Concert Band and plays with the Royal Oak Symphony and several chamber music groups. She has taken a break from her career as a music teacher to raise her family. Lillian Dean on clarinet plays with the Royal Oak Symphony, Warren Concert Band, Terra Voce Ensemble, and Quintet Cantabile. As a master composter and environmental planner, she works with and teaches volunteers at the Sakwa Gardens. Walter Dean on bassoon plays with the Detroit Medical Orchestra, Royal Oak Symphony, Orchard Lake Philharmonic, Warren Concert Band, and Quintet Cantabile. He is a retired chemistry professor. The trio's second piece tonight comes from the ballet Swan Lake. First performed in Russia in 1877, and thousands of times since, to the delight of families throughout the world. The ballet is based on a Russian folktale and tells the story of a princess turned into a swan. We will now hear the dance of the little swans. Imagine, if you will, the dancers on stage dressed as swans and moving together in perfect by Leo Delibes in 1883 as part of the opera Lakmé. The duet features Lakmé, daughter of a Brahmin priest, and Lakmé's servant Malika. The ladies sing with delicate grace as they walk to the river to gather flowers. Thank you. Habanera is a Cuban dance in slow duple time, the dance of Havana, Cuba. I've been to Cuba a few times visiting our sister congregation in Manzanillo, but that's on the entirely opposite side of the island from Havana. The WIndscape trio will perform two versions. First, the Habanera aria from the well-known opera Carmen by George Bizet. Carmen was first performed in 1875 in Paris. Carmen is a fiery gypsy girl working in a cigarette factory. When the opera opens, she comes out of the factory and sings the Habanera to tease and seduce Don Jose, an army officer. Please listen now to the familiar rhythm, a slow duple rhythm, as played by Walter Dean on the bassoon. Listen again for this rhythm in our second Habanera, written in 1984 by the Cuban-American musician and composer Paquito de Rivera. De Rivera is the winner of 14 Grammy Awards, celebrated for his artistry in Latin jazz as a clarinet and saxophone performer and as a composer. We will listen now to the evocative rhythms of both habaneras. If you're watching at home, feel free to get up and dance in your living room like nobody's watching. And if you're here in person, this church is a judgment-free zone. Go for it. Thank you. musician and teacher based in Reston, Virginia. 2 years ago, the WIndscape Trio searched for pieces by current female composers, and this is one of their favorites. Bellata is one movement of a larger composition titled Hymns of Late Summer. The mood is playful, with the instrumentalists almost sounding like children happily playing together at the end of summer. The next flower in tonight's bouquet might resemble more of a shamrock as we turn our gaze toward the Emerald Isle. Turlough O'Carolan was born in 1670 in a small Irish village. Blinded by smallpox at the age of 18, a family friend, Mrs. McDermott Rowe, helped him learn the Irish harp so that he could earn a living. She then provided him with a horse and guide. O'Carolan spent the rest of his life traveling around Ireland, singing, performing, and composing hundreds of tunes in the homes of his friends and patrons. Tonight, we will hear two of O'Carolan's Celtic tunes. First, Captain O'Kane, and then Lord Inchiquin, both named for his patron.
Thank you.
grew up in New Orleans. His mother was of French Creole heritage, and his father a businessman from London. The Dying Poet, also called Meditation, was written when Gottschalk was 35 years old. He composed the piece in 1864, 1 year before the end of the Civil War. The piece combines feelings of loss of life with nostalgic remembrance. As we come to grips with our own multi-layered grief from the past 18 months and gaze with hope into the future, this seemed a fitting selection. Publications, wrote and edited several hundred pieces for chamber ensembles. He was also a professional flutist and woodwind doubler, performing in famous big bands. As tonight's musical bouquet comes to a close, we will hear Holcomb's Trio in the Jazz House. This piece is a jazz waltz arranged by Carson Rothrock and transcribed by Bill Holcomb's son, Bill Holcomb, Jr. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Many thanks to the WIndscape Trio, our wonderful musicians this evening. Also, thanks again to Mike McGinnis and the Downtown Development Authority here in Berkeley. As we move into the fall and beyond, make sure to eat, shop, and support local. Go